All right, here we go. We're at the Sissel Collection. Denny's going to narrate some areas about the car just shortly after this. You're looking at a 1932 Ford Roadster built by Steve Moal, hand-built for the owner. These cars, when they're built, are, you know, today are about 400K. This one's a one-of-one built for the owner because of the stretch in it, which he'll explain in another part of the video. Just kind of do a walk around on the car. Give you an idea, the car does have 22,000 miles on it. When we go in the engine compartment, I'll tell you about that. It is a steel body. These lower panels are louvered, and they are aluminum, hand-stamped aluminum. The undercarriage video will cover all the suspension, but this is a full torsion bar suspension car. Tubular chassis. Power steering, four-wheel disc brakes. These tubes to hide the gas are custom. You can tell it's been driven. The front end here's got some bugs and rock chips on it. The Outriders plaque does not go with the car. It's copyrighted. They must stay with the owner. There are no exceptions. He's going to have this front piece refinished and touched up at Crash Customs here in Lake Havasu to the new owner. We'll cover a lot of stuff on the car with the owner narrative in a few minutes. This hood, again, we're going to cover it, but it has a 4-inch stretch on it, and the body itself has a 2-inch stretch in the doors and a 2-inch stretch in the back. Incredible driving car with the powertrain combination in the rear end in it. The owner says it'll do 85 miles an hour all day long at about 2,000 RPMs. What you're looking at is a reflection of the brake rotor in the body panel itself. A better view here. These louver vents go all the way back here. And at the tail. And the back end has a louvered custom body panel. No sissies, this is a car you can drive. It's not a trailer queen. It's as nice as one though. There's a few small areas, there's a little bit of a spot right there. Nothing to write home about. See the bricks, the pavers in the side of the finish on this car. Guinea has driven it. There's a little wear and tear, but that's what makes it cool. All right, here we are with the owner in the Steve Moal built 32 Roadster. The owner had this car built himself. He has a book with every piece of tube as it went together, basically. Is that what you said, Denny?
Start to finish.
I'm going to kind of let him tell you about the car. It is one of one built by Steve Moal, and he's driven it. So he built it to drive it. It's been to Pikes Peak and back. And tell me about the body, Denny.
It started out as a Brookville body, and then they only use certain portions of that, and then they hand make the rest of it. The hood is 4 inches longer than a stock 32. Have been stretched 2 inches. The cockpit has been stretched 2 inches.
So the hood's stretched 4 inches typically on a Moal car, right?
Yeah, a stock 32 hood is 32 inches long. This is 36.
Okay.
And because we cut the doors and added 2 inches to it, 2 inches to the cockpit, there's more room for one, and the doors are more proportionate to the car that way. And because we stretched it 2 inches, we stretched the wheelbase from a standard 104-inch to 106-inch, or 112-inch wheelbase. It's 6 inches longer than a stock 32, so it rides better, drives better. It's got a lot of little subtle things, like custom-made dual cowl vents because of the Duval windshield. And I like cowl vents, so you cover up the stock cowl when you put on a Duval. The doors here have been made like a 36 Roadster. A standard stock 32 comes clear back here, and it's kind of square, so this has all been rounded. The belt lines down here have been changed. They normally go this way. I had them do them the other way to match the roll pans. Just little subtle changes throughout the car, just built the way I wanted it built. It's Steve built a hell of a car, and it's pretty much an all handmade car. One off steering wheel, one off gear shift, pedals, got the Moal heater in it. The gauges, the only set of gauges like that. I will tell you that has a club I belong to, the Outriders logo in it. It's trademarked, so if somebody does want to buy this, I will have a set of custom gauges made of their choice to replace them, or I'll have to check with the club and see if I can leave them in there.
Okay, and this V8 wing is sterling silver, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
And there's a sterling silver SCTA badge down on the heater there.
He has driven the car. It's got 21,278 miles on it. Just to kind of give you an idea, Denny's done a lot of trips in the car. Obviously, go ahead.
It's been to Canada twice. All through Colorado, all over the place, actually. And I drove it to the top of Pikes Peak in the mud before they paved it. It's a driven car. It's been worked on and made sure everything's perfect. This Joker is a club in Northern California. That I had that made and put it on there, so we can call it the Joker car if you want.
There's the Pikes Peak hill climb.
Not during the race, 4 days after the race.
Okay.
All the mirrors are Steve's. He makes those. All the interior is done by Tom Sewell, a very well-known interior guy for about 40 years for hot rods. He's the guy that did the upholstery in the Don Spencer Roadster when Bruce restored it. I had him do something that I've never seen until then, but I can show you on the other side while Brian's filming it. I do a lot of long drives to Indianapolis and stuff, and I always carry stuff, and these are one-handed pocket doors. They fold down. This is a pad that goes around here for your leg when you're driving. So you don't
around the shifter.
So this doesn't gouge into your leg. But by doing these reversed, you can put stuff in from outside with one hand. You can get stuff out of it while you're driving. The inside of these pockets are not glued in, so if it gets debris in them, you can pull them out like your pocket on your Levi's and shake out the stuff. Just little things like that. Tom does all his interiors now. He does the doors upside down. He calls them Denny doors. It has little indentations for a little more foot room. The tunnel's concaved with a aluminum plate in it for your foot to rest in for the throttle.
And the engine's offset to the right a little bit to give the driver more room.
And to get the power steering.
And to get NASCAR power steering in it. With that said, I'm going to do a little walk around on the car. I just thought I'd let the owner tell us about the car and its history. All right, let's take a peek under the hood here. Almost makes you want to grin. See the no Roush sign? The only thing Roush about the motor itself is the valve covers and the air filter assembly. It was originally built with a Roush motor that has been completely went through by Dan Van Aken at Lake Havasu Speed. They had some issues and Roush wouldn't take care of it, so bottom line is the motor is producing now about 426 horsepower at the rear wheels. The oil pan was redesigned and custom with baffles in the pan. They put a new air gap intake on it. It does have NASCAR style power steering.
Has the new heads.
The new heads on it. This is race car style hydraulic clutch master. And then front and rear brakes masters are both separate. There's a VIN stamp right there.
And on the brake pedal, there's two rods, one on each side that goes to these, and you adjust the bias on the brakes by adjusting the length of the rods.
Okay. Does has custom built reservoirs. That is a serpentine belt drive. What's the cubic inches on it, Denny?
405.
Okay. So it's a 351?
Yeah.
Okay.
Stroke
351 with a stroker. Now these side panels do come off, but there isn't any need to take them off. There's attaching points here and here and here.
Okay, a short little break in the video there so we could raise the hood up a little bit higher and cover a couple more items.
All the brackets on the front of the motor are all hand-built billet, polished billet. For the belt drive system. I know I said it had a serpentine belt drive system, but everything's custom made so that it'll fit within the car. That's why these cars cost so much as you. Well, there's a lot of hand-built items in it. Obviously MSD. Take a better look at the hood here. You'll want to stick around to the end of the video. We do have the car up on a lift so we can kind of go over the things on the undercarriage wise and what it's driven by. It is a Tremec 5-speed transmission with a aluminum Curry housing, I believe, and Positrac rear end. And I just call this badass, is what I'd call it.
One other thing about it, Brian?
Yes.
Is the engine, trance, and everything is above the frame rails, so nothing will ever hit on this car.
Don't know if you caught that or not, but all the powertrain components are above the frame rails. And they'll never bottom. And also the front, the frame ends before the front torsion bar suspension, so it will never bottom out, and there's huge travel in the back end. With that said, I'm going to let the owner tell you about the car, the rest of it, in the next piece here, and then we'll transition to undercarriage, and we appreciate you stopping and taking a look. And we do will have trunk also. Thanks, Denny. You know you want it. Turn it to that way. Okay, straighten the wheel. Okay, the trunk release is right there. And on the other side, there's a battery shutoff. He's opened the trunk. All tubular structure. Whose body is it, Den?
Brookville. Started with Brookville.
Started with a Brookville body, but it does have a 2-inch stretch in the doors, custom done, 2-inch stretch in the rear forward quarters, and the nose is traditionally stretched for.
And because we travel, this is all moved in, so you have more room.
Yeah, you can stuff more stuff in there.
And then another thing that I had to build in this car is... I had room, I had them put me a toolbox that holds a complete toolbox full of wrenches and anything you want to carry in there. It doesn't take up any trunk space.
Very nice. I was wondering what that box was underside. Okay, put it back together.
This is all a little room that's not carpeted or nothing. It's
not a cardboard panel. This is all aluminum panel that's covered. Oh, it's actually finished.
Yeah.
Those are all aluminum panels that are finished in a satin tan. All right, here's the soft top, hard top. It's custom built by Steve Moal for the car to fit the car. Does have a rear window. And who did the same person that did the upholstery is
Tom Sewell.
Tom Sewell. It is a soft canvas,
all
tubular innards. Will be placed on the car before she leaves.
You don't see a lot of good-looking tops that fit Duval windshields.
Yeah, this fits the Duval windshield nicely. Okay, I wanted to show you another little thing here because this always becomes a point at the end of the sale. Usually license plates stay with the state, and they do. In this particular instance, because it's this plate is an original Arizona 32 license plate. They're worth anywhere between $800 and $1,000 value of the car, and it would be used only as show purposes when you get the car, if you were to use it. Behind this license plate,
frame, which is custom made. The adjustments for the rear torsion bar are in there. But the license plate is included with the car. It is a copper plate, correct, Denny?
Yeah, solid copper.
They're hard to get. They're very expensive. But in the effort to keep this car for a show situation only, the plate will go with the car and remain on
the car. All right, we're going to take a look at the undercarriage here on this Moal built car, Steve Moal built. The chassis are all hand built. The suspension is a torsion bar suspension. Drilled slotted rotors, I believe those are Wilwood discs. There's the torsion bars right here. Now this car has been driven, proven and driven. It's been to Pike's Peak. We'll talk about the engine under the hood, but it's a originally a Roush built motor redone by Lake Havasu Speed Equipment. It's got about 426 horsepower at the rear wheels and 500 foot-pounds of torque. This chassis is stretched 2 inches over what Steve usually does. Cost to build one of these cars is about $400K today. Most guys don't drive these cars when they're done. This client does. Tremec 5-speed transmission. Total tubular chassis. These rail panels are actually aluminum and louvered on the side of the car. You'll see that on the outside of the car, or you've already seen that. Remote oil filter. What's that?
Power steering.
Does have power steering?
NASA power steering like they use in NASCAR.
Okay. There's the adjustment for the torsion bars, which is easy to change the ride height should you decide to do so. Sure, go ahead.
Power steering box is right here.
Right. Nice.
Because of that, this motor is offset about 2.5-3 inches. So you have a little more leg room or foot room in the driver's side. So it's not so tight.
The welds, all the heat, the car's got heat shield on the bottom side because the owner planned on driving it. It is a steel body. We'll talk about the body in a different part of the video.
The pan's a handmade 10 quart race pan with baffles.
Custom made oil pan. Dry cell battery. Heat wrapped exhaust. This shield right here is a custom designed by the owner in Lake Havasu Speed. They wanted to channel the air underneath the car so that it didn't heat up the trunk and it passes out underneath the back of the car. His wife's makeup would melt in the trunk on long haul. The rear suspension is also torsion bar. You really can't get a look at it, but how big's that fuel cell, Denny?
16 gallons.
16 gallons.
All stainless.
Again, drilled slotted rotors. Those, I believe those to be Wilwoods. The rear differential is appears to be a Curry housing. Typically, Steve did not build these cars with posies. This has been upgraded to a Positrac rear suspension, rear differential. Fuel pump, fuel filter, obviously. Show you the outside of those panels. Are right here. They're louvered and it does channel the
the air out of the car also.
This car will never bottom out.
Never bottom out?
No, the chassis stopped before the front axle, and there's 14 inches of travel on the back.
Wow. If you caught that, there's 14 inches of travel in the rear suspension. It'll literally never bottom out.
And the frame stops before the front axle. As you can see right here, this is the end of the frame.
Right, so it will never bottom.
Yeah.
Other than that, we're gonna go ahead and pull this car down off the lift. This will be the end of the video. It sounds like it's the beginning by saying that, but we will document the car upside. This will be the tail end of the video. You'll want to see more at spudsgarage.com. Absolutely cool. Backing off the lift after looking at the undercarriage, you'll see that towards the end of the video here.